Hello.
I observed that while evaluating this solution, many students have made some mistake and there are some issues regarding concepts while solving this problem. So, based on request of some students, I am resolving this problem for you. However, while solving this problem, you also have to solve it with me. So be ready with your pencil and paper. We'll solve this problem together. Thank you. Read the problem statement carefully now. Thanks. As there are some issues while solving this problem, we will solve this problem slightly differently than the way in which I have solved previous problems. So, I will read statement and student are supposed to take down the given data on their own. And once my problem statement is complete, I will write down what is the given data. And then students should check whether given data which they have taken and given data which I have shown is matching or not. So let us start. Line PQ has its end P in HP and Q is 50 mm above HP. Its top view is inclined at 30 degrees to XY and has length of 40 mm. The other end Q is in VP. Now, please take down the given data from first three lines of the problem statement. You may pause the video for a minute. Okay. Once we have taken down given data from three statements, let us go to next statement. Draw its projections, find its true length and true inclination with principal planes. Now take down whatever is asked in this problem statement. You may pause the video for a minute. I hope everybody is ready with the given data. Now let's see whether your given data is as taken by me. So basically line is PQ. Its end P is in HP, that means P dash, small p dash equal to 0 mm above HP. Then Q is 50 mm above HP means small Q dash equal to 50 mm above HP. Top view is inclined at 30 degrees to XY. Top view of line PQ is small PQ, or let's say top view is plan length. Plan length is equal to 30 degrees to XY and 40 mm in length. 40 mm in length. And top view angle is with respect to XY, that is beta. Beta is already given, beta is 30 degrees. Other end Q is in VP. Other end Q is in VP, that means Q is 0 mm front of VP. So Q is 0 mm front of VP. Now pause for a minute and check if your given data which you have taken and which I have shown is correct or not. So you may pause this video for a minute. Now if you have made some mistake in taking down the data, probably your solution is not going to be correct. So if you have made some mistake, please verify where you have made the mistake, and then please revisit basic concepts of point and line. Now let us go to next part. Draw its projections, find its true length, true inclination with principal planes. True length is TL, TL is how much, theta is how much, and phi is how much, and what is projection. That's what is asked in this problem. Now wait for a moment and see whether your data, whatever is required to be solved or whatever is asked, is matching with whatever I have taken. If it is matching, then probably you are on right track. If it is not matching, then probably you need to revise the concepts. So wait for a moment here. Okay, I hope now given data and whatever is asked is in place. Now let us start to solve the problem. For a moment, ponder what should be steps to solve this problem. I guess you have come up with the first step, that is drawing XY line. So let us draw the XY line, 150 mm long. And let us label it as XY. Okay. Now, for a moment, ponder about the data. Which data we can draw right now and which data we can't draw. You may pause the video, you may think about it, which data can be drawn. Okay, let's get back to the solution. See, here plan length beta cannot be drawn directly because they need starting point. You may not be able to draw P dash, Q dash and Q. You only can draw locus of P dash, locus of Q dash and Q. So you may start with drawing locus of P dash, Q dash and Q. So I will wait for a minute, or you may pause this video for a minute, draw the locus of P dash, Q dash and Q. Okay, if you have drawn it, let us see whether locus of P dash, Q dash and Q are matching with whatever I am drawing. So locus of P dash is XY line, locus of Q is also XY line, locus of Q dash is 50 mm above HP. So let us draw 50 mm above HP. Okay, and now let us annotate it as locus of Q dash. There is no need to show locus of P dash and locus of Q as both are on XY line. Okay. So now let us wait for a moment and think how to proceed from here. You may pause the video. Okay. Now let us start to solve problem. Understand that whatever maximum information available, you have to utilize it about a point. So point Q is having information about front view and top view, whereas point P is having information about only front view. So obviously you should start problem with point Q. If you have decided or you have judged that starting you are going to start problem with Q, so probably you are on right track. If you have not done it, so then there is issue. So side by side, please draw the point Q dash and also draw the point Q. Okay. I hope you are also with me and you have drawn locus of Q dash and locus of you have drawn Q and Q dash. If you have drawn like whatever I have drawn, probably you are on right track. You may also show the dimension at the same time. Okay, dimension should be in ISO standard above and precision should be 0. So if you have done it like that, probably you are on right track. So point Q dash is fixed, point Q is fixed. Now let us ponder over what is the next step which needs to be taken. Okay, so now if you have thought that okay, I know the location of point Q, I know plan length, I know beta, so I will also know location of point P, then probably you have understood the problem. So here basically plan length is nothing but distance between small p and small q. So this is in context with current problem. So let us draw the plan length. Plan length is 40 mm at an angle of beta is 30. And obviously in this course we are going to have all the problems in which line is in first quadrant. So point P cannot be above xy line, but point P should be below xy line. So the moment location of point P is fixed, it also fixes location of point P dash. Okay. Now here just ponder for a minute and see whether you are also thinking on same lines. If yes, then please draw the shapes and you have to make it bold. Okay. Idea is that here you have utilized whatever given data is there. You have utilized beta 30 degree, you have utilized plan length which is equal to 40. If you have done it, then you are on the right track to solve the problem. Now let us ponder for a minute. Still, though projections are complete, whatever is asked is not complete. Two length theta and phi are required. So wait for a minute, think about how to get projection length of how to get two length based on the given problem status. Okay, so if you have come up with the strategy, then it's okay. If you have not come up with the strategy, then let us see. Generally, in order to get locus of true length, we need to have locus of both the points or at least one point. So let us get the locus of point P also. Okay. So once we have got locus of point P, let us mark it as locus of P. Now this is elevation length. If you rotate elevation length, you make it parallel, then top view of like, and you take it in top view, then you will get true length. So let us see. Center start and end, you have rotated your elevation length, you have made it. So basically you have made this elevation length parallel. Okay. I'm just showing it for sake of understanding. This is not to be done in actual problem statement. So this you have rotated the elevation length parallel to XY line, and then if you take down that elevation length on particular locus of point P, then you will get true length of PQ. Okay. So make sure that you have snapped to the correct point. If you have done this correctly, okay. So here for a moment, what we can do? We can once again show this angle in such a way that it is not conflicting with any dimensions. So now we have got theta also, we have got phi here, okay, and this point is nothing but P1. Now next task is to get the theta. So for getting theta, you have to rotate your plan length so this is new plan length basically, and confusion in this problem is only because of this plan length, which is basically matching with XY line. So this was a peculiarity of this problem. Okay, so if you join this, this is basically point P two dash, okay, and then you have got this angle theta. Now you may ask how to verify whether solution is correct or not. Just check whether your true length, how much is your true length. It is anyways asked in the problem. 64 is your true length. Okay. And let us move P2 such that it's not conflicting with any other labels. Also, you may move everything slightly below so that your dimensions don't clash with the problem, and also check whether true length in top view is also getting same. Okay, it is 64 only, so you have got true length in top view and front view same. See, in top view you have very less space available, so you should not show true length in top view, but instead you should show true length in front view. Also, whatever you have made parallel to XY line is not required. Moreover, whatever additional part is there in the problem, you should not keep it. You should delete this part, and then you should move your problem. You should move your levels near to the actual objects, and now this is your complete solution. Here this 30 degree angle, you may show it like extended angle also like this, okay, because then it will not conflict or it will not be looking congested. So this is the solution. Most students have missed the point that you have to rotate elevation length parallel to XY line and plan length parallel to XY line, and then you have to take those dimensions in, like elevation dimension you have to take it in top view, and plan length dimensions you have to take it in front view to get the true length locus. So this idea is missed by many students, and they have rotated true length incorrectly, which is actually against the concept, basic concept. So So make sure that what you are rotating is very important. So if you have understood this, then please go ahead and solve the problem once again without taking reference of this video. Thank you.